it back up. We'll do one more. I don't know how long. We will see. That's another spot. If I come up here tomorrow, I'm going to park up in that parking lot. Come up here and test that out. Because that, you can't tell from here too well on the phone, but there is enough depth there. There's got to be something. There's spots up and down this like that. All is just around the corner. I am looking forward to it, but it's like my favorite time of the year. But it's so short. There's literally like 3 weeks of fall that are just perfect. Absolutely perfect. And then everything turns brown real quick because we'll get a cold snap and that kind of does it. Like we get one cold snap and that turns the trees. And we'll get a second one and then that turns in the second time and everything turns brown. And that's usually the point where everything falls off of them. Which it's still pretty up here. But after the second turn, it's when all the animals, all the predator animals start foraging. And it gets a little bit creepy to be up here without a gun. There are bears up here. I know there's coyotes up here. I've seen evidence of them. But I think maybe once I did see a coyote. Just one though. And then there's honestly a bunch of porcupines. I've seen a few of those. The good thing about fall up here is, you know, that time of year comes around, the snakes start going into hibernation. It's just, you gotta watch out in the early months of fall. The early couple weeks. You gotta watch for them. They'll be out laying in the sun, out in the wide open. They are easy to spot. It's the one time you gotta be careful. Like I said, I've never seen one. Not a anything of significance. But there's a lot of cliffs up here. Which is seems like where they like to hide. I'm guessing because the rocks stay warm. Because they're getting hit by sun half the day. That's where they'll be, and then if you get any kind of rocky outcropping along these trails, I'll be out late and cross them, maybe coiled up if it's early enough. There's some neat bugs up here too. I just haven't. Every time I've come up here the past 2 years, I've had him with me, and it's hard to investigate bugs with him. He just has no interest in ones. Wants to keep going and going. Oh yeah, I did hit 151.69 miles for the month of August. That was the best I've done yet. Best we've done yet. Merlin protested a little bit towards the end. I think he's just getting older and tired. Sweet boy. Come here. Oh. Come here. I guess. Oh, what's it gonna hurt? I'm just not too... You know what, buddy? No. Because there's places of this trail that I don't know. Come here, sweetie. Come on. Come here. We'll do this part next time. I know I said that before, but... Stop. Stop. Okay. I know I said that before, but I need to come up here and walk out part myself. I don't want to get lost up here with you. I mountain biked that trail one time. We deviated from the trail. And there were parts of it that were... It was really hard to see the trail. And it was fall. I don't know what that trail looks like in the summer. But there's also places along that trail that have massive rocks. Honestly, it'd be better to come down it than to go up it. It's the upper part of the trail that I'm not 100% sure about. I gotta do some mapping. That way I can pause Strava and have something to like look back on in case we do come off the trail a little bit. And I'm not afraid about losing time on that trail today. I mean, it is 5. We still have plenty of light. It's not real long. I just want to be sure of where I'm going on it. And like recognize the places where I need to shorten up the leash. Grab a hold of his harness, because there is some huge rocks he might slip and fall down into. And maybe it's for the best that we skip that today because of how slippery everything was. This part of the trail seems fine, but there's like a good 50-60 yard section of that trail. It kind of gets gnarly. Like when I mountain biked it, I had to walk my bike up those parts. I did slide on my bike on them a couple times. It's a next time thing. I might actually come up here and bike it once I get a new bike. Or fix my old one, I don't know. I'm still thinking about what's going on with that. I'm probably gonna get a new bike. The current one, the derailleur hanger snapped. The derailleur was already bent up in the rim a couple times. Happened like 3 or 4 times. So the derailleur is hosed. My back rim is cracked and bent. It's got multiple flap spots in it. It's just time for a new one. And I was thinking, since I'm already putting that much work into it, every time that derailleur got bent up in the rim, I was shifting. So I'm gonna put probably either a 9 or 12 speed setup on it, probably a 12. It's just less shifting. Less opportunity for that derailleur to get bent into the rim. And just from the ones that I've ridden, a little bit of reading that I've done on them, I guess they shift quicker. So that'd be a neat thing. I'm gonna get hopped off here. This part of the trail coming up is a little bit slippery. I almost fell on it a couple times this morning, well, this afternoon. So, I'm gonna pop off here. And, finish out this hike with Merm. We got about, I don't know, 3/4 mile to go. It's a beautiful day for a hike. I'm glad we came up here. I haven't done much on my vacations. The long weekends I took last week and this week. I had a 3-day weekend last weekend, 4-day on this one. It was nice. Nice relaxing, stress relieving hike. There's been enough of that. So thanks for watching if you did. Appreciate the views that I get. I'll try to do some more exciting, more in-depth things for you guys that do watch them. Or maybe, like I was saying earlier, at least a podcast with some content to it. But, we're gonna pop off here. This was, September 1st, 24 hike up at Forbes Forest. Down the Fish Run Trail. I don't know, we just kind of stopped at the bridge. You hear that crow, buddy? Yeah, thanks for hiking with us. Stay healthy, stay active. You know, generic motivational exit statement. And stay blessed, guys. Until next time. See you in Maryland. We'll catch you guys on the flip side. That was a dorky thing to say. I'm bad at saying goodbye. I'm like real bad with Midwestern goodbyes. I just keep going. It's still happening. Actually, I wonder if we're up at this part of the trail. It gets really pretty. It is like an 18-minute video. I'm kind of risking it. I'll just pause it. I'll hop back on. Okay, this was the part. And I'm at 19 minutes. It's gonna delete this video if I don't make it real short. But I love this part of the trail. It's like real cool right here too. It's so nice. But yeah, this is what the entrance to that coming into this trail looks like. Hobblebush is the name. Sign's right up here. Oh, please don't delete. We're almost done. Alright, here we are. But thanks for hiking, guys. I'll see you around next time. Take care.